Bippity boppity boo!
We're back.
That was so cheesy.
It's all good. It's all good.
We
hope you like cheese. Because we're cheesy.
So today is going along with our fairy tale theme. So we are in the castle. Whose castle is this?
Mine.
Wow. All right.
It's so okay. I can be the queen. You can be the princess. It's Gucci.
I'm your fairy godmother, obviously.
Oh, well, then there we go. All right.
Shoot. Yeah.
Even though I have a wand. It's good. It's good.
Got that magic touch. Speaking of magic, magic is used a lot to, like, transform a lot of our favorite, like, storybook characters or fairy tale characters or even our, you know, our Disney characters and stuff. So transformation is what we're going to talk about a little bit in our Devo. And so it says, in many well-known fairy tales, a character is transformed by the help of some magic from creature to human or human to creature, things like that. And so in the same way, God is our agent of change and transformation, not magic. It's God. So he's the one who works in us and in our hearts.
He is the magic.
He is the magic. He's that little sprinkle spice that we all need in our life.
And so, everything nice.
Yeah, I got two verses for you guys. Romans 12:2 says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. There's a lot packed into that verse, but the main point there is that when we renew our minds and become more and more like Christ and learn more and more about God, he's going to transform us to become more like him. And he's perfect, so I'm always trying to become more like him. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. So we are a new, transformed creation when we are in the hands of God.
All
right. Yeah.
I love it. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, you guys. So for today's craft, we're going to get a little bit messy compared to all the other ones we've done. Yeah. And we're actually going to make dragon eggs. So,
what?
Everyone's going to have a bit of paint.
Aren't these going to be time capsules too?
They're going to be time capsules too. I was going to explain that in a little
bit.
And there's gems, glitter, some clay. You guys have paintbrushes. And of course, some recycled Easter eggs. So, for this craft, we're going to basically make this into a dragon egg. But you can also leave it open or kind of leave it in two sections. So you can create a time capsule. And what our idea was for the time capsule is so that you can basically write down on a piece of paper, fold it up and put it away in this egg, and basically describe how you were feeling during this whole quarantine, the COVID, all the new changes, you know, so that one day in the future, hopefully when this is over, because this needs to end.
Straight up.
ASAP. You can look back on it and recall what you were feeling.
That's good.
And you might wonder, why would I need to remember what I was feeling? And it's just that as time passes by, you get so busy, the more you grow up, the older you get, the more you do. So you forget little things like that. And there's times when I've looked back on the things I wrote, especially in my teenage years, and I'm glad to see, you know, how I used to feel. And I'm also glad to see that I've grown, at least in my mindset, from those writings that I've written down. Mm-hmm. And it could be something small. It could be an essay that you fold up and put it in there. Whatever you want to put in here. You could even put objects in here from your childhood or whatever.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be just
words.
It
could be like a sticky note too.
Yeah.
It could be short, something sweet. Also, you can put the date on it.
Yeah, you definitely should put the date on it.
July, whatever, yeah. 2020.
2020.
So that way, if you ever open it back up, you're like, oh yeah. Because like, I know for me, I keep old journals and stuff, and every once in a while, I'll go back and read them, being like, holy cow, things have changed, and I have grown, and I have transformed, if you will. So, yeah.
And if you do put objects in here, you could include in your writing why you put those objects in there, because, you may have more things to say about them now that it's fresh versus when you're older, and you've gone through so much in life that you don't remember. So, the first step is to basically get our clay and get right into it.
Clay!
So, everyone got about this much, a little handful or a fistful of clay. And the first thing you're going to do is basically kind of thin it out. Play with it if you want to. Warm it up with your hands. That actually does help. I'm going to do that. Warming it up?
Warming it up.
Mm-hmm. But you don't want to play with it too long because this is air dry clay. So if you leave it out too long,
okay,
it's going to get too dry. So you don't want to do that. But if that does happen, you can go ahead and just dip your fingers in a little bit of water. Just dip them real quick and start working with it because a little bit of water goes a long way with this,
yeah,
and it'll make it runny super fast. So don't pour water into it. Just literally dip your fingers and work with it.
Awesome.
Okay. And you'll know it's ready when it's easier to push into and crush with your hands.
This is so satisfying.
I think it's good to go now. So I'm gonna thin it out, not too much, but all of this clay should be enough to cover your entire egg. Not the inside, just the outside, the surface of it. So you can get it to be pretty thin. I think this should cover
like a pancake.
Yeah, it looks like a pancake. So it should cover my egg. And I'm gonna just go ahead and cover it. And then kind of try to spread it. So now that your egg has been, let me get it in there. So I kind of want to smooth out all these little wrinkles with my hands gently. I don't want it to fall off of the egg. Just kind of press, move it around a bit.
Ooh.
And it doesn't have to be perfectly smooth because the gems are gonna add texture to it. So it kind of looks better when it's a little bit bumpy. So don't like completely, you don't want a completely smooth Humpty Dumpty egg. That's not what we're going for here.
Dang, we love the fairy tale reference there.
Thank y'all.
It's awesome.
I didn't realize that. But I'll pretend I did it on purpose. Just kidding. Okay, so this is a part where if you want your egg to be a time capsule, you separate gently.
I'll leave my non-time capsule.
You kind of press it.
Or you can always
crack
like
it like a real egg.
That's cool.
Yeah. And then just kind of leave. Make sure the edges are going to close together. Or you can do what Abby suggested, is put your letter, your items, whatever, in before you put the clay around the egg. But this would be a good time to do it.
Yeah, you could do it before, and then can't you in like 5 years just completely crack it open?
Yep. Yes, you can.
What?
But awesome. If you didn't want to like ruin it, this would be the way to go.
So that's probably the better way.
Because even though this can be a time capsule, before it gets open, you can use it as a paperweight, decor for your room, a gift for someone. Maybe the stuff inside is for someone specific, a family member, you know, someone special to you.
Ooh, a special somebody. Do you have a special someone that you would give yours to?
I don't know. Myself, I'd give it for myself.
Wow.
I'm that special
not
somebody.
Your special someone.
No.
Wow.
I give my heart to my special someone. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it this way so you guys can see what's going on.
Yeah.
So this can go one of two ways. You can either paint it first and then stick your gems onto it with the wet paint, or you can stick your gems on it first, allow it to dry, and then paint around your gems. I like to paint it beforehand just because I just think it's more fun that way.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go ahead and scoot these over. I'm gonna start with a pink. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna just go ahead and take my egg. So you can mix up your color and your two colors that you've got, and come out with three colors, and then do little patterns on there.
Mm-hmm.
This is a
little ombre action.
Yeah, this is the most. Oh, that's beautiful. Should be able to dry without drying your clay so that you can press the gems into it. While my second half of the egg is drying, I'm gonna go ahead and grab my gem.
Clay bag.
And my glitter.
Your glitter?
Glitter.
Ari, she wants to use the glitter. Ari.
Okay.
Can you hit me that glitter?
Oh, yeah.
Alright, accents only from here on out.
I can't help it. Then I'll be stuck on it forever.
Alright.
Alrighty then. So I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle some glitter. Make it fun. Ooh, so pretty.
What's up with this one? There it goes.
While your paint is still wet.
There's not a little bit on the top.
That way. Yeah, I did that with my other half. That way it actually sticks. And you could even do this sort of thing.
Ooh. Give a little touch.
Press them in, because if not, they'll kind of stick out. If you don't care, then let them be. But if you do, and it bugs you and you don't want them to fall later, go ahead and press them in.
Yeah.
Like I said, this one is a messy craft, so.
You're gonna get your little hands dirty.
And now, pour out a few. Little gems. Here you go.
Alrighty, you got gems here. Gems. What do I do with it? Better me say.
You just kind of grab them and start pressing it into the dough. You don't want to just let it sit on there. It's not going to just stay. It might stick with the paint, but over time it'll fall off. So you want to press in. Make sure it stays. It makes sure that the clay surrounds the edges so that it's secured in there. And you can make patterns, you can make a smiley face, you can make a letter out of the gems, like of your name or initials for whoever it's gonna be. But I'm gonna just kind of put them all over the place so they really look like a dragon egg.
So how do you know that this is what dragon eggs look like?
I don't, use my imagination and I follow that. Because I really don't know. I don't think anyone knows what dragon eggs look like.
I do, I've seen one.
A real one?
So I was in Hawaii, actually. That's where the dragons live.
Really?
And we were just exploring, walking around, and we went in this like cave-looking thingy-majig. And we walked in, and we were just looking around, and there on the ground was this egg. It was like this big. No way. It was like speckled pattern, pretty colorful. Mm-hmm. And I just knew in that moment it was because it was a dragon egg.
Nice.
I only speak the truth.
As you can tell. Quick little tip, if you're having a hard time picking it up with your fingers, your hands should be, you know, a little oily, so you can kind of pick up the little ones like that.
What's your favorite fairy tale?
You know, I never thought about that, what my favorite fairy tale is. But
what
I do.
What's the one that like comes to mind?
They all like flash before my mind when you said that, honestly. So I couldn't tell which one was first, but I do have a favorite princess. And it's Snow White. What about you?
Fairy tale?
You get all fairy tale.
Ooh. I know, I always think Disney.
Right?
It's hard to like remember all the classics, you know.
Really?
But I always Little Red Riding Hood.
I was Little Red Riding Hood for Halloween last year with my little wolf teddy bear
and
my cute.
Well, I do. Okay, so I like The Wizard of Oz and Little Riding Hood, and then Goldilocks and The Three Bears.
Nice.
That was one of the classics that I read as a child a lot. But if I had to like pick a princess, yikes. I've always really liked Ariel, but also Rapunzel.
She's awesome.
Aww.
Yeah. Those ones are cute.
So I always like donate and then cut my hair, so then I'm always like,
oh, that's really cool.
Yeah, I've done it
that's,
five
you're
times.
You're literally Rapunzel.
I've done it five times.
That's
this
cool.
Is like short for me.
Oh, wow. I should do that. Okay, All right, you guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop right there with my dragon egg because the top is loaded and I don't want the bottom to really have a lot of gems. I kind of like it as is.
So if you have it, egg is looking
beautiful. Ooh. I like how your gems are spaced out. It looks nice.
Thank you.
So if you haven't already put in your time capsule items, right now would be the time. And let me just make sure I'm not putting the wrong side on here. So I'm gonna reopen these little parts because
you don't need to hear it click because it'll still close.
No, yeah, it'll close, but it didn't. When I was painting on it, I guess I pushed down on these because I had these open a little bit. So I'm gonna kind of open them up again, the edges. If I want it to stay open and savable, this is what you're gonna have to do. So it's not that bad, and by now the paint is pretty dry. Probably couldn't hear it click, but
clicked.
And then to kind of
smooth it out
a little bit, yeah. Because either way, it does still need to dry.
Yeah.
And I've kind of pulled up the light color of the clay, so I'm gonna go over it one more time while it's closed.
With paint?
Yeah, with paint.
Oh, okay. Mine was closed the whole time, so my time capsule is
solid.
Is she solid? She ain't coming out for many, many years and many, many moves.
How long are you gonna wait to open yours?
You know.
You didn't lose a finger.
So how long I'm would 20, you wait? So if I had something in there, I'd probably wait 5 years.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool. I'd probably wait till I was like 50.
Oh, wow.
Or till I have kids that are old enough to, like, appreciate whatever's in there with me.
Dang. Do you want to know some fairy tale facts?
Yes, please
while
share.
While you're finishing painting?
Yeah.
Okay, so three things. Number one, a pair of brothers, Jacob and Wilhelm Grimm, you've probably heard of Grimm fairy tales, were the ones who created a compilation of traditional German folk tales. It was published in 1812. That is 200 years ago. And often referred to as Grimm's Fairy Tales. This book contains many of the fairy tales we have come to know and love, like Little Red Riding Hood and Snow White. Snow White was like one of the OGs. Snow White wasn't even Disney. Like, it's that exciting.
Yeah, a lot of fairy tales weren't Disney. Disney kind of just was inspired by them.
Yeah. And number two, the original versions of fairy tales can be gruesome, so they're often rewritten and toned down to appeal to the masses. So they changed Snow White for the evil queen to, she saw Snow White's heart instead. And in the French version of Rapunzel, the story does not have a happy ending. Oh, I've read that before. Have you ever read that one?
No, just saying.
Rapunzel is turned into a frog and the prince is cursed with a pig's snout.
Ooh.
So like, how is it even a happy ending? So some things have been rewritten, which is actually really interesting.
All right.
Ooh,
looks good. Thank you for sharing those interesting facts. There's some stuff I didn't know in there. All right, you guys, so this should be more or less the result of your dragon eggs. We hope you really enjoy the activity, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.